But I was caught up in physical attraction. But to my satisfaction, baby, you were more than just a phase. And if I
ever fall
in love
again,
I will be
sure that the lady is a friend.
Like you.
Hey, how you doing, everybody? This is Sleep, member of Memes and Dreams and Quantum of Robocraft, talking to you, and we've got some balance changes, but more importantly, Robopass Season 2 is out, and man, I'm just so happy. I haven't been this happy in a long time. I'm so happy. That's the only thing really to be happy about in this patch. You can read, of course, all of this information if you haven't already. I will, of course, have it linked in the description down below for you. But what we're really interested in is the stuff down here, the balance changes, and we want to go check those out. So, we have Easter content. Oh my god, that's just, it's so amazing. We have a new mortar, which is already out. People have already probably made like 30 videos with it. I'm sorry, I'm late. I had unexpected delays, man. Life happens. But we're here now, we're doing the video, it's all good. So we got two new parts, some new struts, which is great. The only kind of concern here was for my clan leader, the leader of Quantum, right, TSP Joker. He is level 10,000. I'm still not sure if he actually got these parts. I haven't asked him. I'd assume he would. I sent a note to Chris, so hopefully Chris took care of that. He said he would. So if you have, great job. General changes, we have now got all of our cubes down to tier 1, like the basic ones, which is good, because every bot in tier 1 still sucks. I mean, every bot, because the weapons suck. There is actually, I saw it today, a 70-page feedback form that you may need to fill out. It will be in the description down below as well. Be sure to do that, because Lord knows that's the only way Free Gem gets any feedback from us. They don't watch these videos. Why would they, right? We got mass changes. This one annoys me, the compact cube mass change. So everything gets heavier again, and I don't understand why. People are complaining stuff feels too sluggish, so instead of reducing masses, we're increasing them. It makes no sense to me. Alright, all modules have this new ratio that makes them, I think, almost 3 times as heavy, but they also got a massive health buff, which you should see down here somewhere. What else? All Electro Shields got a mass reduction. Well, I shouldn't say that. The big ones got mass reductions. I think the overall mass went down. So if you really liked using Electro Shields, that's good for you. For everybody else, it's kind of eh. I really don't use Electro Shields too often. Cube health. So light cubes finally got a buff. I'd always said 800, 750 is a little below that. That 50 health, whenever it's, you know, 1500 blocks or so, makes a difference, man. That's a very big difference. Medium cubes got a health buff because damage is just nuts with the weapon upgrade, which has had no adjustment as far as I can tell. That was not in any of these patch notes. It might be in the feedback form. I've yet to go through all 70 pages. I apologize. We got some movement part stuff as well down here. I'm not familiar with the ratios off the top of my head for these parts. I think some got buffed, some got nerfed. That's fine, I'm okay with that. Other health changes, module health got massively increased, man, look at this. It's over 3 times. We went from 202.5 to 750 health per CPU. That's insane. So if you ever used a DSM as the core, quote unquote, for your bot, where you had all the rest of the bot kind of connected to it, this can help out, or it could make it worse, because in some cases, you like to have kind of modules and stuff break off to preserve other key parts. So we'll see how that plays out. I do think that making them heavier hurts them far more than buffing their health helps them. Electro Shield health, I'm not familiar with the ratios on all these health values, so if someone can tell you in the comments below if we got buffs or nerfs. All I see is that the ratio changed. I assume stuff got tankier. That's where we seem to be going. Strut weight as well got a massive increase, a 2x increase. The only strut I thought was really too efficient was the base strut, which was the 3x3x1. So it took up 9 regular cube slots, and it had 45 kilograms of mass, which means that it was more mass efficient to use that strut rather than using 9 regular medium cubes. You would get half the mass, so I guess they're fixing that, which is good. That's all I really wanted to be fixed. This might actually make the Strut Plus, I believe, lighter. And the Strut Plus was kind of a glue part, but it had a massive mass. So, we'll see. I don't know exactly how much CPU they use off the top of my head. Movement parts CPU changes. So, some stuff got way easier to use. T4 wheels got a huge reduction, which is good because they're massive. Like, actually massive. And now you can build around them more easily. But T4 wheels, like, I don't really know anybody who builds cars in Tier 4. You have access to all the other movement types by that point. Tank tracks, this buff does not fix them going up hills. It still doesn't fix them going up hills. It's nuts. Weapon balance changes. Okay. These are a bit weird. Yeah. So as you can see, if you have a singular gun left, yeah, it's going to fire slower than you otherwise would. So if you ever used a single T4 Aeroflak, that was the most common of these that I would see with just one gun. Or if you're an Omega Warrior, shout out to that clan, you would use one T3 Seeker. So if you were using one of those, your fire rate got nerfed. It got nerfed. The flak one's the bigger nerf here. A lot of bots use just one T4 flak, because you can just kind of slap it onto the side, and it was a utility addition. Weapon balance. What else we got? Well, sorry, weapon feedback. Also, we nerfed a proto seeker range, which was the only seeker I was really worried about with range. I was worried about that cross map sniping capability with it, but they've addressed that. Seems like a good nerf to me. Someone will probably complain. So laser, no change. Plasma, no change. The laser, no change, I would agree with if you changed the upgrade system values, but you didn't. Plasma, no change, I completely agree with. I think plasma's in a very okay spot. I would not have touched plasma at all. Rail, definitely needed a nerf. It's still the best weapon in the game, though this increased fire rate now means you can't just go bam, 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 like you used to be able to do, you know, 2-3 patches ago. These are starting to add up. So we're starting to go less semi-auto and more bolt action on rail again. That's good. I like that. But if you're doing that, and I cannot stress this enough, if you're doing that, you need to make it feel rewarding. Because if you, like, whenever you bring down these damage numbers and you make it shoot slower, it's going to feel less impactful. I don't know how you would adjust that to make it feel still better, but whenever you reduce damage and fire rate for someone who's been using the gun a long time, it's going to feel like they're just weaker. Even if they technically should be weaker, like, I don't think anyone will disagree with me when I say rail was absolutely overpowered. So it needed to be nerfed. I like the nerf. I'm just worried that whenever we eventually get everything in line, rail's fire rate and energy usage will not match its damage. Meaning that the rail won't be able to keep up in terms of DPS. Which I guess is the point. It's supposed to be really burst heavy, but if it's supposed to be super burst heavy, make it like 3 seconds in between shots and double its damage. You know what I mean? That's what I would do if I wanted to play it like that, like an actual bolt action rifle. Nanos. This is the most troubling weapon change to me. I've been very vocal in my last patch notes videos about the state of nano and what I want them to do and what I don't want them to do. And what was top of my list was, do not make it more energy efficient, just keep buffing healing per shot. You cannot let nano become again this sort of sustained healing weapon, and we keep doing it, man. Before this patch, I was already seeing nano circles, and they could keep up with damage somewhat. And with the upgrade system, people getting that level 10, that 20% buff to healing per shot, and you give them another buff to healing per shot, cool, but you've given them more energy efficiency. Like, if you have 2 people running nanos on a team, maybe 3, you're gonna be really hard to break. So, I don't like the nano changes. Again, I think that they're overtuning nano too much. I think you should have just left it as a burst heal, kept its energy usage really high, but like if you really need to, you can almost full heal somebody with a bar. You know what I mean? But don't make it where I can keep somebody who's at 80, who's going from 100 to 80% and keep topping them off every 2 seconds. Don't let me do that. Okay, that's insane. What else we got? Aeroflak needed an energy buff. You still eat through your bar. I agree with that. Seeker's no change aside from the T3 Seeker getting a range nerf. That's fine with me. Chain Gun gets a buff, finally. This buff, I have not used it yet, so I cannot tell you how good this buff is, but we are getting an extra shot. Each shot will do 5% more damage. It's going to spin up 5% faster. I don't like this. This should have been a bigger buff to its spin up time and decrease the accuracy spread, which means it's going to be closer together. I like these changes, but the spin up time I think should have been more. Talking 10-15%. The damage per shot, again, you have to hit the shots, which is the accuracy spread supposed to do it, and you have more shots going down range, so I haven't used it. I can tell you it's probably still not going to be very competitively viable. Like, you're not going to see it a whole lot in really competitive matches, like say the World Cup or a clan v clan matchup, but it's probably going to show up more now in just regular casual games. Mortar, no change. Not even the random range buff anymore. I agree. I think Mortar's in a good spot. Tesla's in a really bad spot because drones are dead. So you can't really Tesla people whenever you can't get to them in a very fast and agile bot without getting shredded. I've seen several Tesla hovers and sprinters that have just been shredded, man. Absolutely destroyed. Because they can't get to you quick enough, or they can't get up in the air where we usually are. So Tesla's in a really bad spot. If you're against like an all-ground team though, Tesla's probably still fine. Just no real good competitive group will ever play all-ground. So just be warned of that. Movement feedback. Wheels got a faster and a agility buff. Tank tracks got a buff, but I don't think you can still go up hills with them. Like if you're on Gleese Lake or... with the other snow maps, I can't think of the names off the top of my head. I'm sorry. I don't think you can go up those hills. So if you can, let me know in the comments. And I will, of course, pin a response listing all my corrections so you guys don't have to worry about it. Mech legs and sprinter legs, no change. I thought that the mech leg should have gotten a speed buff. And the sprinter leg should have gotten a speed buff as well. Insect legs, the health needs to still be buffed. I can tell you, whatever health buff they gave it, not enough. Absolutely not enough. Unless you, like, doubled its health, not enough. Skis got a buff after they got randomly nerfed. Good for skis. You still can't turn in ski bots, though. So, that's fun. And skis got really less agile because all the thruster weight increased. Sorry, thruster mass. All the thruster mass increased. So, skis became really, really inefficient. And... skis were always kind of a niche bot. They're really hard to use now. I mean, if you can, and you have a great time, because people can't hit skis for the crap, dude. The hard part about a ski is just controlling it. What else we got? Hovers increased agility. They still, I don't think, have fixed the center of mass issue. And I'm going to put that clip in right here. You can see what I'm talking about with that center of mass thing. It's nuts. Absolutely nuts that that's a bug with this game. Maybe they have fixed it, I just haven't seen it, but that is nuts to me. Alright, rotors, we've decreased agility. So, disregard what I said like 3 weeks ago about rotors being the best. No, don't disregard it. They're still the best movement type. Easily. They just nerfed the agility, because I guess we really want rail to be good. So we're making stuff that could potentially dodge it less dodgy, less evasive, easier to hit. Less mobile? I don't know. I don't know what we're doing. I really don't get it. We should be making stuff more agile, not less. Wings. Wings got buffed. Whenever rail is strong, which rail's been strong for 2 years, planes are not strong. Planes are still not strong. Do not think that this is going to help planes out at all. It won't. Thrusters got a weird buff. And of course... here are the voting polls for the last feedback. You can click on them and read them at your own leisure. I will again, of course, have everything linked down in the description below. But what I think is really going to come out of this patch, what do I think the meta is right now? Let me break it down. The meta team comp, a meta five man, will most likely be this. A dedicated medic with DSM and power mod. That's going to be number one. You're going to have probably two railers. Still two mega railers. Both are going to have an energy mod. One might have nano, or they might both have DSM. Then you're going to have two SMGs, and both are going to have side nano. So you're going to have two mega SMG bots, both with power mod and both with side nano. And if you only have one rail, my guess is that you are going to be running another plasma bot with energy mod and EMP. I say EMP, I truly believe that EMP is going to become very effective with nano circles coming back and agility being garbage. Look out for EMP in competitive matches. I will certainly be testing it, and I think it's going to do really well. But with that said, that's all I've got for you on the patch notes. If you like it, drop a like. If you don't like it and disagree, think that my take is wrong, let me know about it in the comments down below. Subscribe if you're new around here. Click that bell icon so you don't miss a video. And I will catch you guys in the next one. Take care.